Here is the Writer's Almanac for Saturday. It's the 14th of September, 2019. It was on this day, 1320, Alighieri Dante died from malaria just months after completing Paradiso, the third and final part of his Divine Comedy. He died in exile from his beloved city of Florence. He'd been exiled because he supported a revolt against the authority of the Pope, Pope Boniface. Dante was a member of the White Party, which wanted the city of Florence to remain independent from the Vatican. The Black Party wanted to form an alliance with the Pope. Dante went to Rome, tried to negotiate with the Pope, but while he was there, the blacks took over the city of Florence, and he got the news that he had been banished. He was stripped of his wealth. He spent the rest of his life wandering from city to city in northern and central Italy, estranged from his family, often living in poverty. His only solace was writing his epic poem, The Divine Comedy, and he spent the rest of his life working on it. It's the birthday of the physiologist Ivan Pavlov, born in Ryazan in central Russia, 1849. His father was the village priest, and Pavlov was going to go to seminary, and then he read Darwin's work, got interested in the study of science, got his medical degree, and left religion behind. He could not reconcile his passion for scientific proof with the life of faith. He went off to Moscow to the Imperial Medical Academy, where he was the chair of the physiology department, and there he studied conditional reflexes, and he did his famous experiments with dogs, who would salivate when the lab assistant came through the door with their food, and then would salivate when the lab assistant came in, whether the lab assistant had food or not. It's the birthday of Barbara Grizzuti Harrison, Queens, New York, 1934. She was a travel writer. Her parents came from southern Italy, from Calabria. She was an essayist, wrote autobiography, had a very troubled childhood, an abusive father. Mother suffered from mental illness. Family joined the Jehovah's Witnesses, and Ms. Harrison renounced her faith at the age of 22, went off to Greenwich Village, lived the bohemian life, and began writing feminist essays. She came out with a memoir, 1978, Visions of Glory, A History and a Memory of Jehovah's Witnesses, in which she portrayed the faith as harsh and tyrannical and sexist. Though she was an agnostic when she began writing the book, she experienced a spiritual epiphany in the course of writing it and converted to Catholicism. Barbara Grizzuti Harrison, whose travel essays, particularly about Italy, are still very popular. Here's a poem for today by Emily Dickinson, Going to Heaven. Going to heaven, I don't know when, pray do not ask me how. Indeed, I'm too astonished to think of answering you. Going to heaven, how dim it sounds, and yet it will be done, as sure as flocks go home at night unto the shepherd's arm. Perhaps you're going too, who knows? If you should get there first, save just a little place for me, close to the two I lost. The smallest robe will fit me, and just a bit of crown. For you know, we do not mind our dress when we are going home. I'm glad I don't believe it, for it would stop my breath, and I'd like to look a little more at such a curious earth. I am glad they did believe it, whom I have never found since the mighty autumn afternoon I left them in the ground. Emily Dickinson's poem, Going to Heaven. And that's the Writer's Almanac for September the 14th, 2019. Do good work and keep in touch.